And welcome back to Game 5 of the 2011 Australian Grand Final Backgammon Championships. And Tony Kosak, we see there that after the first four games, Cliff, the previous champion, has hit the lead.
That's right. It was an impressive break for 4-2 over Tomirsky, and Tomirsky's got to be feeling some pressure right now. He really needs to step up to the plate and show us exactly why he's here. I feel a little bit of confidence for him, though. I still think he's got some magic to pull out of the bag.
Oh, yes. Look, he did appear to be a little bit shaky and not sure of himself in the previous game. But, look, he's been playing wonderfully all year, and I'm sure he's very much ready here to equalise the scores if he can.
And we're underway for this game. Let's hope it's a good one for Brian, and obviously Cliff wants to just maintain his lead here if he can.
Yes, I think so. Well, Cliff will be hoping to even improve his lead if he can. He's got himself a 6-1 right from the beginning. And, always a good thing. And there's Brian scoring one of his favourite scores, the double 4.
Yeah, it is it's a nice roll to roll in the beginning. You have a few choices. Unfortunately, he separated his paired couple in the Cliff's space there, which made that one a little bit unfriendly for him.
That's right. I don't think he's too concerned about it, but Cliff is putting him on the bar.
Well, this is becoming a little bit of a trait to this tournament, isn't it? He's learning to live on the bar, Paul Tomirsky.
Yes, he has spent his time there, and Cliffy also has been there a couple of times, but I think he's been teaching the newcomer to the game some of the tricks that you learn after the many years playing that Cliff has had.
This is a nice one for Tomirsky. He's managed to use the double one to his advantage there, filling in his home base the way he likes to do it.
Absolutely, and Cliff's responding by getting one piece out as quickly as he can. And I'm afraid, unfortunately for him, he's going to be sent back in.
Oh dear.
Back in on the 1 point and with a 6 to move. And the cube. Brian Tomirsky offering the doubling cube. And Cliff is taking his time here, Tony.
Well, you would imagine he's thinking everything through. He's taken
he's
the cube. There.
He's taking it.
So I believe he thinks he will win this one.
Yes, I think so. I hope he's not overconfident just because he's in the lead, but he normally would not accept a cube if he really had doubts about it. He must be feeling he's got a strong potential to win the game. But I don't like the look of him still having his two pieces trapped in the far corner. And especially there is a 6-point blockade from Brian. So that's all Cliff can do at the moment is try and come up close to the blockade so that the moment it shortens, he can skip out of there.
Yes, that's very impressive. Tomirsky's really done that quite quickly on the slide.
Oh, look, he's playing beautifully. Look at his positioning. And Cliff hasn't even got his own home corner in the kind of order he would like it to be. He loves to fill in the points, but look at that from Brian Tomirsky.
Yeah, this is a really smart gameplay from Tomirsky. He's not letting any pieces go. He's going to maintain that blockade. I suggest he's probably going to move them in very slowly from the back end, as he is now doing. And this is just putting Cliff in a position he does not want to be in.
That's quite correct, yes. Now he's still got to keep waiting for to escape that distant corner. Go, Tomirsky still preserving the 6-point blockade. Beautifully done.
You've got to imagine that Cliff is really regretting taking that 2 points now. That's got to be giving him some stress.
I think it's going to be worrying him. He can, meanwhile, get some pretty good positioning in his home corner, but yes, it's going to be a big ask for him when he finally gets out of there to actually get all the way home and win.
So he had a miss roll there. He rolled into the cup.
Moved into the edge section, obviously an illegal throw, and so he's had to replay that throw. Yet another double 4. Brian Tomirsky.
Well, he's just going to take these straight off, isn't he? He's not mucking around now. He's on his way out.
He's in the liftoff phase, and he's going to get as many as he can off. He knows that he's got Cliff cornered there, and Cliff has to basically wait for the right throw to be able to escape from there.
Yeah, well, I don't think I like his chances of winning if he purely escapes. He's going to have to leave one there in the hope he can take one of the pieces from Tomirsky, sending him back to the opposite base. That could be his only chance.
Well, that's right. Meanwhile, he's going to work that piece. Now, that's right, he'd prefer to leave that piece distant so that he's got some space, so that he doesn't have to remove his distant piece immediately. He's just waiting for the opportunity, and Brian makes it even harder for him. Got to come off the bar again, and he's delayed, he can't get in.
Oh dear, well, Brian's basically opened it up for him and said, there you go, you can come on in, and
that's right.
Good luck to you.
And look, quite honestly, Cliff now has got the bigger task of making sure that he can lift off, otherwise it's going to be a four-pointer game. Come on, Cliff.
Still a two-point game, though, for Tomirsky. He's going to win this one.
That's right. Look, he could still win. Oh, he could have won the whole game there, but Cliff gets the last shot and he's on liftoff. He's just showing the piece to prove it. So there we go. 2 points there to Brian Tomirsky, which equalises the scores at 4 points all.